In Namibia's most southern region, about 50 kilometers northwest of the Nuer-Uvu border post with South Africa, lies a settlement called Awusenge, a diamond in the desert.
Welcome to Awusenge.
Awusenge's success originates from the fact that grapes here can be harvested 3 to 5 weeks sooner than anywhere else in the world. The settlement has been the backbone of Namibia's multi-million dollar export grape sector since grape farming began in 1995. Awusenge is located in the district of Carisbrook West with a special school system nurtured by the Director of Education in the Caris region, Mr. Johannes Kusep.
One of the things that are misunderstood by people about Awusenge is that given that the grape industry is a multi-billion income generating project, many people are under the impression that all is sound and well with the community here in Awusenge. They think that the people are rich, everybody is rich here in Awusenge, and that we are all enjoying from the income that is coming from the grape. But you will find that here in Awusenge, we have people that are employed, gainfully employed, but also an equal number of people that are not employed at all. There are children of parents that are mostly from households where it does not go very well in terms of income. And there are children whose parents are a little bit well off. That's one thing that people do not understand about Awusenge, the contrasts. It looks like a place of plenty for everybody, but it's also a place where you will see poverty. It is greatest.
The ethnic groups represented in Awusenge include Ovambo, Nama, Kavango, Kaprivi, Herero, San, Baster, Ovahimba, Tswana, White Namibians, and the Damara people. While the elder generation at the farm often insist on returning to their homesteads when their working life ends, the younger generation has a different retirement plan. They know that their community gains immensely from developing this region. This is done through a public-private collaboration focusing on safety, well-being and future of children and youth. Christian Nober founded the Kindervorden Zukunft Stiftung Foundation, known as Support Children, Enable a Future, in 2009. His ambitious notion to aid children and compensate those who have made a significant contribution to his professional achievement as a publisher of a children's magazine led him to create the foundation. Among other things, Kindervorden Zukunft Stiftung created the Lis Alam project in 2011, which will, however, be discontinued in 2023. The foundation also initiated and carried out the Paternoster Volunteer Project in South Africa between 2016 and 2017. Mr. Kusep was informed in 2019 by now-retired Inspector of Education, Marcela Crawford-Snyman, about student volunteer work being done by the German Foundation in South Africa. The regional director approached the foundation and inquired about expanding the project to a school in the Caris region. Micah Reinhardt, the foundation's project manager, then visited the 6 schools along the Orange River in September 2019, with the board of the foundation ultimately deciding that their vision and mission best fit the Awusenge Primary School and Awusenge Farm context for implementing the project's first replication in Namibia, while also acknowledging that no blueprint is exactly replicable when working with communities. Christian Neuber's dream then took shape under the scorching Namibian sun at the Awusenge Elementary School, which initially opened in January 2000 as the village's only school. Since 2014, the school's enrollment has grown by more than 62%, from 513 students to 821 students, 3 non-teaching staff to 5 non-teaching staff, and 14 teachers to 27 teachers. Since the start of the volunteer project, there has been a noticeable improvement in learner performances. Because of Germany and Namibia's different lifestyle, it allows teachers more freedom to vary their methods in the classroom. It also allows teachers to monitor and evaluate their own performances. Leonie Niels, a grade 2 teacher, found a chance to begin her career at Ausencare Primary School, and the settlement's vibrant energy has kept her teaching for 7 years.
Ek het 'n paar woordjies vir ons. Okay, wie is volgende? Rolensia. Tak. Okay, wag eers. Ruben. Ons almal weet Ruben leer nou eers Afrikaans. So Ruben, lees vir ons.
Favorite part of the work, it's how children think. It's so fascinating how they come up with ideas and imagination, like how to solve a problem. It's just like the simple things, and it's fun to work with learners every day, because every day you hear a different story, a different challenge, and how they cope with that challenge they have.
Many decisions were made at the first stakeholder meeting, and developing a sustainable volunteer structure was one of the first steps the project had to take in order to have a fruitful interaction with the assistance from the Ausencare Primary School teachers. With this level of commitment underpinning the project and the fruitful collaboration between Johannes Kusep, Saisiya Shangangange, the school inspector in the Karas region, as well as Susanna Kadikwa, the principal of the Ausencare Primary School, Maika Reinhardt from the German Foundation, Kindervorden Zucken for Stiffenton, and the support of Tanya Tate, counselor of the Namibian Embassy in Berlin, the way to a prosperous future was paved. The first volunteers arrived in Ausencare on October 3rd, 2020, with the vision of equipping the youth for the future while preserving their local heritage. These volunteers have qualifications in education, social work, and begun under the direction and guidance of the foundation's primary principal, with the role of supporting teachers at the school, as well as developing and implementing a life skills program with a focus on reading to benefit children and youth.
As a part of the volunteer project from the Foundation Kinderfördern Zukunft Stiften, we are on the spot here in Ausencare Primary School, working together with the teachers, cooperating with them. We have the opportunity to help them if some teachers are missing, so we can assist in the classes. We are able to help them with some kids with learning difficulties to just put a bit more focus on these kids, because it's just not possible in a class with more than 40 kids sometimes.
When we first came here, we saw that the classes are quite big and the teachers don't have the chance to support every child individually.
Hello, my name is Annika and I'm a volunteer here in Ausencare for the volunteer project at the school of Ausencare Primary. So one of the key points of this volunteer project are the afternoon workshops we are doing, and we do that so the kids can do something in the afternoon. Each day a different grade is coming. For the grade ones, we have 2 days because they are also in school and two different types. And so they can choose in the workshops between sports, arts and crafts, singing and dancing. And they can just choose by their interest.
The afternoon workshops enable students to acquire a variety of skills that cannot be fully developed during class time, because these skills are developed through practice. Board games are also very popular among children. Learners' critical thinking and problem-solving abilities are enhanced by board games. With volunteering, comes volunteers' own initiatives, such as Jakob Meyer's Science Club. Jakob Meyer, who is currently studying secondary school education with geography and technology subjects, discovered an opportunity to lay the foundation in science for students.
Since 3 weeks, I'm offering a science club for some of the grade 7 students, and the club is taking place at Tuesday and Thursday in the afternoon. We're always working around 2 hours, it depends how long we need, and yeah, we're doing some practical and also some theoretical part or work, because for me it's important that the students are not always doing the theoretical part. They also should know and learn how to do or how to work in a practical way. So we are doing some physical experiments, like the leveler or how a free fall or something like that. And I also teach them how to ironate something or how to solder.
My name is Hilka Malakia. I am a volunteer of the AusenCare project. I am a graduate in library and information science, and I am currently helping with the new establishment of the school library.
The school library serves as the intellectual hub of the building, similar to a central marketplace. The truth is, however, that the 800 plus students at AusenCare Primary School, ranging in age from preschool to grade 7, all share a small number of books. The foundation has prioritized reading for the past 10 years in Germany and wants to do the same in Namibia at the AusenCare Farm Primary School.
The library is the most important part in the school setting, because it is a second place where children can learn. And most importantly, it provides information resources to the teachers and the learners. In that way, learners will be able to explore the world in all corners of the globe when in the library, especially through reading and discovering other materials that are in the library. And therefore, we are really, really wanting to have this new establishment of the library, because it's going to be bigger, which will accommodate or cater for 100 learners at a time, as well as we will have ICT facilities.
27-year-old Max has already done many things in his life. He has a degree in marketing and communications and worked in advertising for a while. He also worked as a bartender in South America, but somehow that was not enough for Max, who wanted a life that was more meaningful.
We are the future, window of hope, smart and steady. Perfect! Go! Yes, perfect. Okay, so the lesson we have now, it's called a window of hope, and we do it just for educate, to give the learners some special social skills and go deeper in some important topics. Right now we are talking about ourselves, to increase our self-confidence, and about things what make us feel special. But in the lessons before, we had also like some hard topics like rape or like teenage pregnancy, which is very important to show the learners that they, if something terrible happened to them, they just have to go to the police or just go to the social worker or to the teacher to get the help they need. Do you know any people who make you feel special? You know, raise your arms. Your mother. Yeah, wow. Yeah.
The The foundation has committed itself to showing children how they can shape their own lives regardless of their social and economic background, even in the less privileged regions in the world.
So we restarted our gardening project in the beginning of this year after the last term did a quite big project with the help of some grape companies to put up a protection net around our garden to keep the garbage out. And we are basically now taking care of all of our vegetables, which we planted in the beginning of this year. We want to give some learners the opportunity to do some practical work in their free time to learn something about planting. We are hoping to plant some grapevines soon, so they can also learn how to plant the grapes, which are quite popular, of course, here in Außenkehr.
Moving abroad and volunteering in remote areas, as Max and the rest of the Außenkehr volunteers are doing, can be difficult. Homesickness is one of the most significant challenges that people living abroad face, particularly those living in another country for the first time. Making new friends can help some people overcome homesickness, while others, such as the Außenkehr volunteers, transformed their living space into a home with shared chores like preparing dinner and dining together while reconnecting with the memories.
And you know, guys, there are so many experiences that I remember throughout our time here in Außenkehr.
Volunteering goes beyond personal satisfaction. A random act of kindness can have a long-term impact on a project like the Kinderforden Zucken von Stiftenten and the lives of the people it touches. There is no one solution that will fulfill the community's needs, but a combination of what has been proposed will lay a solid foundation for transitioning this community to a place of greater sustainability and improved quality of life.
Everybody.